and as someone for whom universal credit is soon to become my reality, I brought this motion to our Young Members Committee for Disabled People Against Cuts, DPAC. This is a group we can all look to, creative campaigners who have fought back tirelessly against a government who has been found guilty by the UN of grave and systematic violations of the rights of people with disabilities. My Young Members comrade Claire has succinctly spelled out why this is an ideological choice and why we absolutely must not waste any more time saying that this can be reworked or this can be fixed. And so I'm going to use my speech today to give you my story about why this motion means so much to me. I have chronic fluctuating health conditions. This time, 2 years ago, I was bedbound, mostly unable to do anything and in almost constant pain. My life was hospital appointments and getting to grips with the benefits system. Not that surprisingly, this is when I became political. As soon as I was up to it, my first trip out with my parents, who had become my carers, was the launch of my Unite Community branch. Out of work and unwell, Unite Community gave me a purpose again. I met passionate campaigners who shaped me into the activist that I am today. And I tell that story here because although I'm now in the industrial sector, I will always fly the community flag. Our Unite Community brothers and sisters have been campaigning on universal credit since Ian Duncan Smith first announced this Tory flagship policy. These comrades should be here today. They should be speaking on this motion. And I hope everyone will consider why these brilliant activists who have supported so many strikes, picket lines and actions supported so many of you in this room have not been given the voice to shape the policy of our union. But I'm here today as someone for whom both the community and the community and not-for-profit sector of the union make equal sense for me. Due to my disabilities, I will be in and out of part-time work forever probably. I'm currently on ESA, Employment and Support Allowance, and the DWP allow me to work up to 16 hours a week under a scheme called Permitted Work. This scheme is scrapped on Universal Credit. And Universal Credit is coming to my area this month. It's anyone's guess when they'll move me over to it. I have no idea what I'm facing. I have no idea whether I'll be forced to apply for more or different work, or if my income is due to change. And so I wait. I know this horrible thing is coming, but I know that I'll get through it. I've got parents I can live with and no dependents. But not everyone does. There are so many people who have no security. They will have to take out loans. They will have to take out jobs that make no sense for them. Their mental health conditions will worsen. Their physical health conditions will flare. They won't be able to afford to get by. And so I'll finish by saying that I've been so pleased this week to hear Len McCluskey, Steve Turner, my regional secretary Pete Kavanagh, all say during this week that they support young members and they want us to have our voices heard. Well, conference, I ask you to listen to us. As both advisors and claimants, your young members are saying that this system is not simplified, this system is not streamlined, this system does not work, and it is harming us, our families, our comrades, and our communities. We must scrap universal credit. Thank you.